Welcome back, students. Today we will discuss a new topic, that is translation. So before going into the today's topic, we will recap whatever we discussed in the yesterday's class. In yesterday's class, we discussed about the protein biochemistry. What is the structure of a protein, and what is the secondary, primary and tertiary structures of a protein, and how the proteins are made up of. The proteins are made up of a small units. Those are amino acids. All the amino acids coming together, and they are bonded with the help of a peptide bond. So as a result of that, a long polypeptide chain will be formed. Polypeptide, that means the peptide bonds are more. That means automatically the amino acids will also be more. So this lengthy polypeptide chain, either it will like that only in a primary structure, or it will start folding into form in the secondary and tertiary structures. So this is how we discussed about the protein biochemistry. And today in this class, we have to know about mutations. Before going into translation, we will go through mutations. What are the mutations? Mutation is nothing but either a change at the DNA level, either the change in the mRNA level. So as a result, what will happen? The new protein will be formed, or sometimes not at all, the new protein will be formed. The protein will be formed due to that mutation. Sometimes the poisonous or the most toxic proteins will also be formed. That will lead to expression of new characters. And finally, sometimes it may also lead to lethality. That means the death of that organism. So how the mutations are? Either it will be deletion, insertion, deletion or insertion. That means the sequence may be, some part may be deleted, or some new part will be added. That is deletion and insertion. And the mutations may be deletion or insertion. And in this only we can see point mutations. Point mutations. Frame shift mutations. So what are those? We will see in details. For example, this is a DNA strand that is going to be formed into mRNA. That is going to be formed into mRNA. That means the DNA is 3' and 5', that is template strand. So here we will take a sequence, whatever it may be. Like this. Now what will happen? Deletion and insertion. For example, this is deleted due to some error occurred in the process of replication and process of transcription. And for example, this was deleted. Now what will happen? This is not present. So this is mRNA. This is mRNA. So now uracil, and this is not there. This G is deleted in the DNA level. So next A will come. Uracil and complementary uracil and complementary adenine. C, G, G and A. Now what happened? Yesterday we discussed about codon. That means three nucleotide bases or three nitrogen bases. Three nitrogen bases will form as a unit. So this three will one unit, this three. Now what happened? Actually another G is replaced. G has to be there, but G is not there. So what will happen? As if you take this case, C G T A G A. So these are two and these are two codons. But here what happened? C G A U U U. See, this codon is completely different from this codon. Entire codon was changed. If the codon was changed, the amino acid will also be changed. If the amino acid changed, the protein is also changed. See, even due to the deletion of a single nitrogen base, the entire protein structure is changing. This is very important. That's why the mutations plays a very important role in the process of evolution also. So many mutations are taking place since 4.5 billion years. Because due to deletions and additions, for example, this is we discussed about deletion. Now, if you discussed about addition or insertion, so in between these two, one nitrogen base is added, for example, that is C. Now, in the mRNA, again, we will write complementarity. This is example model only. Like this. Now what happened? Actually, these three codons, 3 and 3. But here what happened? GCA. This is okay. But at the place of insertion, the entire sequence was changed. New thing came. So here also the new codon, due to new codon, a new amino acid will come and add. And due to new amino acid, the protein structure will also be changed. So now we will take an amino acids and we will compare the mutations. In your textbook, they had mentioned an example. Ram has cap. Ram has cap. That is, this is one amino acid. Arginine, alanine, methionine, histidine, alanine, serine, cysteine, alanine, proline. Carefully observe, from DNA sequence, mRNA will come. From mRNA, peptide chain will come. Protein, that is protein. So now we are talking at a protein level. Protein contains amino acids. Now, for example, if any mutations takes place here, the same thing reflects here. So due to some mutation, one amino acid was added here. See then, for example, here. Some new amino acid is added, that is B. So what will happen? The protein structure will also be changed. Understanding? And another is changed, another is added. So due to addition, the new structures will come, new amino acids will be formed, new proteins will be formed. So these mutations are very important, which will play. Sometimes the mutation will be good and sometimes the mutation will be very bad. That will lead to death of that organism also. And if the mutation is not accepted by the nature, slowly what will happen? The nature will eliminate that species itself. So that much dangerous. Sometimes the new mutations will be favorable for the environment and the nature will select those organisms. So like that, new mutations, like in dinosaurs, several mutations have happened and those are not accepted by the nature. That's why the nature was deleted, that means extincted or eliminated from the earth. So that's why as a result of that, the dinosaurs are extincted now. Like that, so many species are extincted because the mutations are not favorable, are not accepted by the nature. Understanding? So this is about mutations. Now we will see the protein formation process, that is translation. That is translation. So how it is occurred? As we discussed, the transcription process from a DNA strand, that is from the template strand, we are getting the mRNA. And the mRNA is matured or modified into matured form and releases from the nucleus and reaches to cytoplasm. So what happens and what is the fate of that mRNA that leads to the production of proteins, we will see now. So before that, we have to know some basics. As you know that the cell organelles, ribosomes, are also called as protein factories. Because the protein synthesizing function was done in the ribosomes. That's why they are called as protein factories. So how, what is the role of ribosomes here? We will see now. Ribosomes is having two subunits in eukaryotes that are having 80S type of ribosomes and 70S. Now we are discussing about 80S. So here this is 40S subunit and this is 60S subunit. Understanding? Now actually in the cytoplasm these two are not bind with each other. Here somewhere 60S and here somewhere 40S. And during this formation of proteins, they will come and they play important role in the process of formation of proteins. But naturally, the two are separate with each other. And during protein formation, they come together. So here, how the ribosomes plays an important role. And now we have to know about tRNA also. Transfer RNA. The name itself indicates that it reads the mRNA and it transfers the amino acids. So what is the structure of tRNA? This structure is clover leaf like model. Clover leaf like model. So this is the structure of tRNA. Here this site is amino acid binding site, and this is D loop and this is T loop and this is anticodon loop. Understanding? So this is the structure of tRNA. This is also an RNA basically. Here also the nucleotide nitrogen bases are present. So what is the function of this tRNA? And how it brings amino acids? And how it involves in the process of formation of proteins? We will see now. So this is about tRNA and this is about ribosomes. And now how the mRNA which is released from the nucleus and reaches to the cytoplasm, what is the fate of that? We will see now. You have to listen very carefully and you have to present at most attentive. Now here the mRNA is released into the cytoplasm. Now this is mRNA containing nitrogen bases. So here, for example, these are the nitrogen bases. So first step, the translation process was divided into three different steps. Again, the same initiation, elongation, and termination. Initiation, elongation, and termination. Understanding? Now, what is the initiation process? Once the mRNA is released into the cytoplasm, the smaller unit of ribosome, that is 40S, is come and it will bind here. The smaller subunit will come and bind here. So this is the first step. Once the smaller subunit is binded, the tRNA will come and bind. Once the tRNA will come and bind, then the larger subunit of the ribosome will come and bind. Carefully observe. First of all, once the mRNA is released into the cytoplasm, the smaller subunit of the ribosome will come and bind. Once the smaller subunit is binded, the tRNA will come and bind to that. Once the tRNA is binded, the larger subunit will come and associated with the smaller subunit. Now, how this process will take place? Carefully observe. So that is the initiation process. And in the initiation process, the initiating codon, as we discussed in the previous class, that is AUG, that codes for the amino acid methionine. So the first tRNA which is coming here, that is AUG. That means, carefully here observe how it is forming. Now I am taking an mRNA strand. This is an mRNA strand. This is containing AUG. And here, A, U, 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 G, A, C, A, G, T, C, like this. The mRNA strand is like this. Now what will happen? How the tRNA will recognize this one? And how it brings the amino acid? So, and one more thing. Each tRNA is specific for one amino acid. One tRNA will bring a particular amino acid. So each and every amino acid has its own particular or specific tRNAs. One tRNA cannot bring two amino acids. It brings only one amino acids. Now, what will happen? As we know, the structure of tRNA, this is the tRNA, and we discussed that this is an anticodon loop. Anticodon loop. Now, it brings the amino acid. That how it is bringing particular amino acid? So many amino acids can come at that time and binds to this one. That means it is recognizing with the anticodon loop. For example, this is UAC. This is UAC. Or this is AUG. As previous, it is very simple. AUG. Now, this anticodon loop will come here and attaches to here and forms a complementarity. That is UAC. See here, AUG belongs to methionine. But this is complementarity. That means here UAC is also belongs to methionine only. Now this sense reaches to here and it will attaches AUG, that is methionine amino acid. So methionine amino acid will come here. See here, again it is making complementarity, then it is recognizing that okay, this codon belongs to the methionine. So methionine should add it reach here. For example, other amino acid is coming here. For example, phenylalanine is coming here. But here the complementarity shows only methionine. So phenylalanine will go outside. And another tRNA will come and it will check. If your complementarity sets, that amino acid will be present there. Otherwise, that amino acid will go. Because that is not my complementarity, I will not bond like that. Now, how this process is continued? This entirely, this is depend upon the complementarity only. Nothing is there here. So carefully observe here. How the elongation, this is initiation process, because the initiation codon always, that is AUG, methionine. See, carefully observe. This is mRNA. And this is the larger subunit. And this is the smaller subunit. One second. Here, carefully, you have to pay attention. These are the nitrogen bases. Now, in the larger subunit, we have three sites. We have three sites. E site, P site, A site. E site, P site, A site. First of all, the first tRNA will come. The first tRNA will come here. And if it is bonded the same, AUG, UAC. So this is bonded here. Now this amino acid will be formed. So one amino acid, that is methionine, that is formed first. That's so initiation was done. But protein contains thousands of amino acids. So how this elongation process will be done? Now, after the formation of this, here to A site, the new tRNA will come. The new tRNA will come. And here, it starts the complementarity with these three. Once the complementarity is confirmed, here it will add, it will bring another amino acids. Now, what will happen? The bond between these two, the peptide bond will be established. The peptide bond will be established. So here, two amino acids. So once the peptide bond will be formed, this it is detached from this tRNA. Now this empty tRNA will reach us to the E site. And from E site, it will go outside. And another again, new tRNA will come and again checks the complementarity and adds another amino acid. And the empty tRNA will comes to the E site, and from E site, it will go into the cytoplasm again. Again for bringing another amino acid. And again, this peptide bond is formed. So like this, the chain of amino acids will be formed, linked by peptide bond. And once the protein structure is fully formed, that final, and this mRNA is traveling like this. This is traveling like this while checking. And finally, the termination codon UAA or UGA or UAG. This, any of this, that is a termination codon. If once this is come here and checked, okay, we have to stop this process. So that is termination. Once the tRNA will read any of these three codons, then the protein synthesis process will be stopped. And now this peptide chain will be released into the cytoplasm for further modifications, like folding or making into the tertiary structure. So this is how the protein will be formed. And once again, I am explaining you, carefully listen. This is mRNA, and this is the smaller subunit. First, mRNA is released into the cytoplasm from the nucleus. This smaller subunit will come and bind. Once it will bind, the tRNA will come and bind. And then the larger subunit will bind. So this is the initiation process. Once that smaller or larger ribosomal unit contains three sites. It contains three sites. That is E site, P site, and A site. E site, P site, and A site. Now, the first, always the protein synthesis starts if the codon is having AUG. So this is a start codon. Once it recognizes AUG, then only the protein synthesis formation will be happens. Process will be stimulated. If AUG is not there in that sequence, that process will not be started. Now, once the tRNA will come and recognize tRNA, the tRNA will come and here recognizes the complementarity. Okay, AUG is only present here. So now we have to start the process of protein formation. So now here it is methionine. Okay, now it is okay. Now the next amino acid, next tRNA will come here. and that will check the checks with the complementarity and adds another amino acid. Once this amino acid establishes the peptide bond between these two, this tRNA will be shed from here and reaches to E site, and from E site it goes into the cytoplasm and it brings another amino acid. Now this was done, and again new tRNA will come here. Now at that time this mRNA is moving like this in this direction. Then again 3 will come, 3 bases will come, and that will checks with the nitrogen, that will checks with the tRNA, and once the complementarity was fixed between these two, it adds another amino acid, and that empty tRNA will reaches to E site and exits. E site is exit site, and again new tRNA will come, and again it will add new amino acid. Like that, amino acid chain will be formed, that is peptide chain. Once okay, the protein was formed, this is enough. That means here that should be UAA, termination codon. Once the tRNA will reaches the reads the termination codon, the whole process will be stopped, and then this peptide chain will be released into the cytoplasm for further modifications. This is how the translation process was happened in the organisms, occurs in the cytoplasm, and the transcription process occurs in the nucleus. But in prokaryotes, as there is a no division, no demarcation between the nucleus and the cytoplasm, so whole transcription and translation process occurs in the cytoplasm. But in the eukaryotes, transcription is in nucleus, translation is in cytoplasm. This is the differences between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. And these codons are universal. Wherever you go, the triplet codon UUU is codes for phenylalanine only, whatever the organism is. And the triplet codon AUG, it codes for only methionine. So like this. So this is about the process of translation. And in the, so here by this video, we completed most of the topics that is very important in the molecular basis of inheritance. DNA replication was done, and what are the differences between DNA and RNA structurally, biochemically, and how the nature, why the nature selected the DNA as a genetic material but not RNA. So that was completed, and how the DNA is only transferring from one generation to another generation without having any transfer of proteins or RNA. That is experiments done by transformation experiments, transduction experiments by Griffith and Hershey and Chase, and biochemical nature was also established. That experiments also we discussed, and now DNA replication was also discussed, and transcription translation process also discussed. And what are the mutations? What is the importance of mutations? How the, which mutations are selected by the nature? So those topics are also discussed. And finally, in the tomorrow's topic, we will see the gene regulation, how one gene is regulated. It cannot do its independently, it has to be regulated. At particular time it has to activate, and in particular time it has to inactivate it. So that regulation, who is doing? So the gene regulation process we have to see. If no regulation, the gene is continuously expressing and continuously it is producing proteins, means it is again toxic for the body. So the regulation has to be there. So how the regulation of a gene will be happened, we will see in the next class. And in the final, we have to discuss about Human Genome Project. So what it is? So these two topics are left, and I will try to complete it in the next video. Thank you so much.